Hello friends, it's Alex here, and today we're in Eastside Costa Mesa on 17th Street at Fishbones Grill. We're gonna get to meet the owner today and learn more about what makes Fishbones great. Let's take a look inside. Hey Derek.
Hey Alex,
good to see you.
Welcome to Fishbones.
Good to see you again. So hey Derek, one of the questions that people wanna know is, how did you decide to start Fishbones Grill?
So, my story goes way back to when I was a young boy. My father taught me, he wanted to spend time with me a lot, and we started to go and do a lot of fishing. So we did deep sea fishing a lot, and almost every single week we were fishing. And as I grew old, I mean, my whole life I've been in the water. I used to surf and do different things. So I've always been in the water. So I've always had that one thing that I always loved was fishing. So that's where I kind of, as I got older, I recognized that I wanted to be in the fish business some way, shape, or form. And my father also taught me how to cook and how to do different things. So I got an interest in cooking too. So the two together obviously was something that I wanted to do for a lot of years. I didn't always have the money to do so, but in the end, that's what I ended up doing.
Other than the money, what was the most challenging part about starting a business?
I think from being a first business of this type, not being in the restaurant business, it was really, really tough to get started because, you know, figuring out the suppliers and figuring out all the different things that you need to do. So it was a learning curve, but you know, with the passion I have for fish, and I knew that my fish was going to taste good, and I knew that everything I had to do, you know. But it was a challenge in the beginning. But I got a good start in Torrance, and I opened up in the South Bay, and I got an opportunity to take over a restaurant that was there, and I ended up buying out the guy that was there, and I changed it from an ice cream shop into the restaurant it is in Torrance, and I was able to test that for a couple of years. I only had a 2-year, but I had options to be able to continue it. So I figured I could do it for 2 years, and if it worked out, then I would go from there. And it's gone tremendously now for 10 years. I just celebrated 10 years in the business a couple of months ago.
Oh, that's great. Yeah. Obviously, with challenges, when you overcome them, that's so satisfying because that means you figured something out.
Yeah.
You know, so what do you enjoy most about being a, you know, restaurateur and business owner?
I think the thing I like the most is that being hands-on in the restaurant, I get to communicate with people all the time, and I like to listen to my customers, and I've moved my menu based on what my customers tell me, and so I'm able to try to do things that are going to be good for them. You know, I always remember when I first opened in Torrance, the first few days of opening, we had these big, gigantic portions, and people would say, oh, I know you're gonna, you know, I know at some point you're gonna switch it and you're gonna have these little small portions, and I always remember that. And so I recognized that this was the most important part of this restaurant, was to make sure that you were getting a good value for what you were getting and a quality for what you were getting. And I knew that if I did that, I would be able to build a business that would have repeatability forever. So that's kind of how I remember it when I first started in the business.
Yeah, I think that's a lot of reasons why people really love your restaurant.
Yeah.
So what is your favorite thing on the menu?
I would say, you know, there's a few items. You know, I can't honestly say that I have a favorite because I know what the favorites are of the customers, but I'm always, you know, I'll eat something for a week and then I'll switch it, and I'll switch it again and again and again. So there isn't really one thing. I think pretty much everything on our menu, we have a very diversified and big menu with a lot of categories, so it's really, really tough to aim in on one certain category, but everything on our menu, I've tried to take some things out, but every single day all the items sell on there.
Oh, that's great. So what have you been eating most commonly lately?
You know, lately I've noticed in Costa Mesa restaurant that we have a little different clientele, so we've been selling a little bit more of the higher end items, like the lobster tails, the Chilean sea bass, things like that, which are a little higher price point, but still at a value price compared to other restaurants that would be double the price of that. So those are the things that, you know, I've been doing a lot with and experimentation with. So.
Fantastic. Yeah, I actually saw an ad for the lobster tail. It looked amazing.
Right.
And hopefully we'll be able to see one of those being made, you know, later today.
Yes, yes. I think we'll do that today. I think that would be great.
Fantastic. And what does community mean to you?
Community, you know, what, especially, you know, the other restaurant opened 10 years ago, so it's been a while since I've had to do this again. And when I opened here, I realized that Costa Mesa, Newport Beach, Huntington Beach, all this area in here is very, very family oriented. I mean, when I opened here, I noticed that, you know, at one side of the room and another side of the room, people are waving to each other and they all know each other. And it's very, a lot of the high schools in the area and stuff, they all know each other. And so, you know, in fact, Newport Harbor High School, I sponsor their football team, their basketball team, their baseball team, and their marching band. And I'm one of the concessions at the football games there at Estancia High School. I do the same. I do that over there. And so we get a good base of people from there, over from Lido Island. We get a lot of people. So it's very community oriented, and it's all families that come here, so which is really, really nice. And that's where I feel I do my best, is when I'm talking to all the customers and hearing what they have to say. And, you know, I'm able to adjust as each day goes by.
No, that's great. And then what do you love serving about the community? Like, why do you love serving the community?
Well, because I hear so many people since I've opened here. It's been a year and a half now, but I hear it all the time, thanking me and saying, you know, we don't have anything like this in the area, and that they're so appreciative of the price point, and that it's good for them, and the quality is so good, and you know, they just, that they love it. And they, you know, I see a lot of the clientele come in 2, 3, 4 times a week. We even have some customers that come in every single day. So that's really, really, you know, what makes me really, really happy. And, you know, I'm, like I said, I'm very much in contact with all the customers, even all Yelp reviews or anything like that. I'm actively, as soon as I get a review, I reply back, and whether it's good or positive or it's negative, whatever it is, I try to fix. And people see that also, and they always say to me, you know, you're very active in that, and we appreciate that. Even if something didn't come out right, we're able to fix it, and you know, we're able to keep all our clientele. So,
no, that's fantastic. I mean, even along this street and in this area, there's so many other options for people to eat at, and even seafood as an option. But people keep coming back because they know what they're gonna get. And you've been able to deliver consistent quality and value. And I really think that if you were not here at the restaurant, a lot of people don't wanna catch their own fish. They don't wanna clean it. They definitely don't wanna cook it. Yes. They would starve. Yes. So thanks, Derek, for sharing a little bit about your flavorful past and basically having a delicious restaurant that people can enjoy at in the community.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Derek, so why don't we take a look at some of the favorite items that are on the menu in the kitchen? Can we jump back there and take a look?
Yeah, absolutely. I would love that.
Great. Let's do it. Joining me on the tour and learning more about Fishbone Grill in Eastside Costa Mesa. Please like, comment, and share. And if you're interested in seeing more content just like this as we continue to see the best things to eat, see, and do in Costa Mesa and Orange County, definitely make sure that you hit the subscribe button. See you soon.